name is Tom Thelen, and today we're talking about bullying. What does it mean to be bully-proof? You know, when I was a teen, I wasn't bully-proof at all. I was kind of the typical victim. I felt powerless over my bullies, and I didn't know how to respond. When you think about the definition of bullying, I want you to think about that word, power. Bullying is the unwanted taking of power from someone. And there's a number of different ways they do that. They do it through physical bullying, through verbal bullying. Sometimes kids use social bullying where they exclude others out of their social group, or they use gossip or rumors to hurt someone socially. And then the fourth type of bullying is cyberbullying, where someone hurts you through an electronic communication. And as a student, I didn't know what to do about the pain in my life. I had so much hurt in my heart that I had hidden for so long that that kid who was bullied started to turn into a bully. Not with my fists, but with my words. See, I was a sarcastic bully. I was like a class clown bully, the kind of kid who got everybody laughing except for whoever was the butt of my sarcastic joke. And guess what? It never really helped the hurts in my heart. Then I could never settle the score. It never felt even. If you try to pay back your bullies, you try to settle the score, it'll never feel even. The score will never get settled, because when you repay hurt for hurt, it only creates more hurt. You know, I go around to schools and I speak to kids about bullying all across America. And as I look at schools' bullying prevention programs, guess what I normally find out? The programs are most often nothing more than a bullying reporting program. In other words, it's assumed that all these kids are going to be bullied. So when you are bullied, here's how to report it. Run and tell, run and tell. Listen, there are a number of times when you need to run and tell an adult right away. And that's if the bullying is serious, or if it's sexual, or if it's repeated. If the bullying gets like that, I want you to tell a trusted adult right away. But most of the time, bullying starts out subtly, doesn't it? It starts out with just the words of someone else or the way you're being treated in a social situation. And you have to learn how to respond in a way that'll diffuse that situation. And so, if your only solution is to pay back or run and tell, it's not a very deep solution, is it? What if you could learn to repay those hurts with kindness? What if you could learn to repay that hate with love? What if you could love your bullies? It's the golden rule, right? Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Now listen, you might think the golden rule was something meant for little kids. It's just kind of a trite little saying. But there's a hidden power in the golden rule. There's a reason why this rule has been taught by every culture of the world. You know, all sorts of religious leaders over the ages have taught this rule in a different shape or different saying, but it's all come down to this. Repay those hurts with kindness, because here's the secret power of the golden rule. When you can relearn in your brain to repay hate with love, it'll actually take the hurt out of the pain. Like, it'll take the sting out of the words of those people who are trying to hurt you. What if you could take the hurts in your heart and you could turn it into love? What if you could look back at those people who are hurting you, those bullies in your life, and say, hey, I'm gonna have compassion on them. I'm gonna help turn that bully into a friend. If you can do that, you can become victim-proof, and you truly will be a bully-proof teen. Take some time in your class today to discuss this idea about becoming bully-proof.